Once upon a time, there was a small village, nestled in the valley, between tall mountains. The villagers had a simple life, but they were always curious about the mysteries of the world. They often looked up at the stars at night, wondering how they could shine so brightly. One day, a wise old man came to the village, claiming to know the secrets of the universe. He spoke of a powerful force that held everything together, from the tiniest particle to the largest galaxy. This force was called electromagnetism.
Electromagnetism is a branch of physics which studies the interaction between electrically charged particles and the electromagnetic field. This field is composed of electric and magnetic fields, which are intertwined and interdependent. Electromagnetism is one of the fundamental forces of nature, along with gravity, the strong force, and the weak force. Electromagnetism describes the behavior of electric charges, electric fields, magnetic fields, and their interactions. It includes the study of the behavior of charges at rest or static electricity, as well as the behavior of charges in motion or current electricity. Electromagnetism also explains how electricity can be generated and how it can be used to create magnetic fields and vice versa.
The villagers were fascinated by this idea and asked the old man to explain it further. He began his story by describing how all matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms. These atoms are made up of even smaller particles, including protons and electrons. The old man explained that the protons have a positive charge and electrons have a negative charge. These charges create an electric field around the atom, much like how a magnet creates a magnetic field around it. He showed the villagers how this electric field could be visualized as lines of force radiating out from the atom. Then, he went on to explain in details about some important fundamental properties of matter.
Electric charge. Electric charge is a fundamental property of matter, which is responsible for the electrical force that exists between charged particles. There are two types of electric charge, positive and negative, and like charges repel each other, while opposite charges attract each other. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. Electric fields. An electric field is a force field which surrounds an electrically charged particle. It is represented by electric field lines, which are drawn in the direction of the force that would be experienced by a positive test charge placed in the field. Electric field lines start from positive charges and end at negative charges. The strength of an electric field is measured in Newton per coulomb. In this context, Coulomb's law is very important. Coulomb's law states that the force between two electrically charged particles is directly proportional to the product of their charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. F is the force between the two charges, Q1 and Q2 are the charges of the particles, R is the distance between them, and K is Coulomb's constant, which has a value of 9×10⁹ Newton meters square per coulomb square. Magnetic fields. A magnetic field is a force field which surrounds a magnet or a moving charged particle. It is represented by magnetic field lines, which are drawn in the direction of the force, which would be experienced by a north magnetic pole placed in the field. Magnetic field lines form closed loops, and they always go from the north pole to the south pole of a magnet. The strength of a magnetic field is measured in Tesla.
But that was just the beginning. The old man then explained that when an electric current flows through a wire, it creates a magnetic field around the wire. He demonstrated this by holding a wire near a magnet and showing how it was pulled towards the magnet. This is the principle of electromagnetic induction.
Electromagnetic induction is the process by which a changing magnetic field induces an electric current in a conductor. This phenomenon is the basis for many electrical devices, such as transformers, generators, and motors. According to Faraday's law, the magnitude of the induced electromotive force, or EMF, is directly proportional to the rate of change of the magnetic field. Mathematically, EMF equals d phi by dt, where EMF is the induced electromotive force, phi is the magnetic flux, and t is time.
This is the basis of how generators and motors work. The villagers were amazed. But the old man wasn't finished yet. He explained how a changing magnetic field could create an electric current in a wire and vice versa. And it was all thanks to the magical force of electromagnetism. In the end, the villagers were grateful for the old man's wisdom and knowledge. They marveled at how something as simple as electric charges and magnetic fields could explain so much about the universe. And they never forgot the power of electromagnetism, the force that binds everything together. One more thing should be mentioned in this context, without which electromagnetism is incomplete, that is, the Maxwell equations. James Clerk Maxwell in the 19th century went on to unify electricity and magnetism by his four sets of equations. He proved that electricity and magnetism are the same force of nature, just expressing itself in different form. After this discovery, electricity and magnetism commonly came to be known as electromagnetism. But how does these four sets of equations works? Well, that is a topic for another day. It will require some detailed explanation on physics as well as mathematics, especially calculus. Let's end it here today. Thanks for watching the video. If you liked this content and found it helpful, then please share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. We will see again shortly. Goodbye and take care.